You did good.
It's good.
It's not
especially
bad.
You guys are just being nice.
Yeah, it is sugar-free.
I really don't think it's bad at all.
Sugar-free, lime-free.
No, lime-full.
Lime-full.
Straight
tequila. 10 limes in there. Thanks again for inviting us over. I mean, this is practically your home. I heard you say that you live on this 38, you travel 38 weeks of the year.
Pretty much, yeah. There's 38 races that we go to. A couple of them are in Charlotte, which are close to home.
But we still stayed on the bus.
Yeah, I still had to stay on the bus for a night because it was a late night before and then an early morning the day of. So yeah, it's hectic.
So what is like a day in the life, you know, of the Bushes where you have your three-year-old son on this bus too?
Yep.
Yeah.
You know, there's toys.
Everywhere.
What's life like living on the road?
Well, you tell your side, then I'll tell our side.
I mean, My life's pretty scripted by schedule. You know, it's always here, go do this. But it's always fun. You know, it's always nice to kind of go to these different places. And now that Brexton's getting a little bit older, we're starting to take him out more and get him to different experiences across the country. And it's not normal for a three-year-old to be jet-setting the country.
He is a jet setter.
He's on an airplane at 10 days old.
Yep.
Oh my God.
He was.
Yep.
And it's pretty cool. Rain delays are tough. You know, when you have a rain delay and you're stuck in the bus, it's basically
just... For two days straight?
It's basically just movie day.
Oh boy.
No, we had an Easter egg hunt.
Yep, we parked him in the bathroom and had him count to about 20 and we hit about 20 different eggs everywhere and then it was
his turn. Oh, that's so cute. He's adorable. If he wants to go into racing, would you welcome a career for him in your field?
Absolutely. You know, people have asked me that all the time, and I'm like, yeah, I mean, if he wants to do it, certainly. You know, I think that my dad, Brexton's grandfather, obviously, has made two race car drivers, two champions in NASCAR, my brother and myself. So obviously there's a pretty good, let's call it bloodline there first, but also a good teacher and good mentor there in Tom Busch. So hopefully one day, if Brexton wants to do it, my dad's still around. He can help us out and make another young boy's dreams come true.
Oh, my gosh.
Sure, that's just what the NASCAR community wants to hear.
I love that you guys, like, are this great team, and you run the foundation together and own the truck racing team as well. So what are the keys to working with a spouse?
I think what's nice is we always have each other's backs, you know,
as much as we
don't have to sugarcoat things and be like, honestly, like, no, this is what I think about this or that. We don't have to tiptoe around the issues, but at the end of the day, you know, we're a team and it's always about each other. So
we both strive to help make each other stronger and we have each other's back all the time. Even if I do something wrong, she'll tell me, hey, that was wrong, or I can do the same with her. But yet we still have compassion and love and respect, for each other as well as our son. And just being able to spend time with one another. Like, we fly everywhere together. We live in a motorhome. We go home. Like, we're never apart. Like, we always want to make sure that we have Brexton with us and Samantha with me and that we can always stay together.
So with the Kyle Busch Foundation, I love Bundle of Joy. And I have to say, like, every time that you guys have given a grant to a couple that's struggling, it, like, brings tears to my eyes every single, like, I've watched tons of the videos. I'm curious what you would tell couples who are maybe going through it at the moment that don't see the light at the end of the tunnel. I'm sure you talk to a lot of couples.
We have.
Yeah. And is it you're at 31 that you that's amazing.
31 couples. You know, it's really hard. Obviously, we know where they're coming from, which is why we started our foundation. You know, when you get the diagnosis that you have to go through IVF, it's your only option to have a child. For us, that was hard to swallow, but then they hand you a bill of $25,000+. And luckily, we were blessed to be able to afford that. But for a lot of couples, it stops right there. So they know what they need to do, and they can't do it. So it's our mission then to help fund them so that they could have their miracle babies.
Because there's very, very, very rare and limited insurance companies that give
any support to IVF. Most of it's completely out of pocket.
Right.
It's emotionally and physically hard. It's taxing on your marriage, on your other relationships, on your body. It's
sometimes with your friends.
With your friends, everything. You know, how it's hard when all your friends are pregnant and you're the only one that's not, and they don't know what that's like. And not that they're bad friends and you don't want to be a bad friend and not be happy for them, but you're so jealous and it's just very hard. And for us, especially too, living in this world where it was every day, why didn't you guys have a baby? Everybody else has a baby. Where's your baby?
And it comes from friends sometimes, family sometimes, not direct family, but outside family, and then you have fans that are asking you all the time, so yeah. Media Nobody, members that are asking you.
Nobody's doing it maliciously, but yeah, we just weren't ready to talk about it yet at that time.
Right.
Because we were just, you know, in a place of hurt, I feel, and so I realized that once we went through it that we have to talk about it because it's helpful to the women that felt like me, felt alone and scared and embarrassed. Yeah, and, oh, you're fine. And so that's why we were so vocal about it. And then we just knew, kind of God placed on our hearts, that we had to do more.
What's something that you want fans to know about your husband that maybe, like, they don't know?
Well, I think a lot of times they can see it now through my social media, but just what, you know, he has this really tough and cool guy demeanor out on the track, and he has this dangerous job, but, you know, behind closed doors, just what a good dad he is and what a good husband he is. He knows how much birthdays and holidays mean to me. He hates birthdays. Like, if we didn't have to celebrate a birthday, he wouldn't care, but he goes out of, but he goes out of his way to make it special for Brex and I because he knows how important it is. And it's the little things like that, or just taking time, you know, to do little stuff here and there for Brex. And even though he's running in and out and has a million people pulling in different directions, he'll be like, no, wait, hang on. You know, I'm not answering my phone. I'm not doing anything. This is time with my family. And so just, you know, the fact that he does all that is really special because he could easily, you know, find a million
other
things.
Come home, sit in my chair, and be on my phone.
Right, but instead he's down on the floor playing race cars with Brex, you know, so that's what...
It's really I love it. You know, it's a history-making season for you, and what do you... If there's just, like, one thing you can attribute to your success, like, what would it be?
Great people. Yeah, you got to have a great support system behind you. It starts with your wife and your son. They're my two biggest fans, obviously, but of course then... it goes to my race team. I drive for one of the best owners in our business, Joe Gibbs, who's been a Super Bowl winning coach in the NFL and who now is a four-time NASCAR owning champion as well. And the people that he puts in place to work on our cars, to build our cars, to sweep our floors at the race shop, to my crew chief and everybody on the road and their families. I mean, their families go through a lot of sacrifice because they are gone and don't get to see their loved ones for 4 days out of the week, you know? So it's very challenging and taxing on them and their families, but, you know, it's just about people.
Well, I could chit chat forever with you guys. So I appreciate you doing this and cheers to your success. And like I'm so excited to continue following you guys.
Well, thank you so much.
I appreciate it. It was awesome to have a drink with.
Yeah. Thanks for having me over, guys.
He's actually really good.
I know, you know, really good.